Present evening to everyone present here. Myself, Dr. P. Sudha, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Annai Violet Arts and Science College. It's my honor to welcome you all on the behalf of Annai Violet Arts and Science College for the second day of the webinar series, New Insights in Science, on the topic Machine Learning, organized by the IQAC and Department of Computer Science and Computer Application. I would like to welcome our beloved Chairman, Savalier Dr. N.R. Dhanabalan, Esteemed Secretary N.R.D. Prem Kumar, Energetic Joint Secretary Dr. P.E.R. Premchand, our Principal Ma'am Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, and our IQAC Coordinator and Vice Principal Ma'am Mrs. Jafia Solomon for this webinar. I am really privileged to welcome our resource person, Dr. S. Bharathidasan, Head Department of Computer Science, Lila College, Chennai. Welcome, sir. I also extend a warm welcome to the HODs of various departments, faculties, students, technical team, and all other participants for this webinar. Our resource person, Dr. S. Bharathidasan, completed his MPhil from Bharathidasan University and has received his prestigious doctorate degree in computer science from University of Madras. He also holds an MBA in human resource management from Pondicherry University. He has more than 16 years of experience and has cleared state eligibility test for professors. He has acted as a resource person for numerous workshops and conferences on various topics such as data science, machine learning using Python, data analytics using R, and data mining using R to various colleges like Idaya College for Women, Mother Teresa Women's University, Kamaraj College, Ethiraj College for Women, Vivekananda College, MOP Vaishnav College, Women's Christian College, and the list goes on. He has also published many papers in Scopus indexed journals and conferences. He is a board member in framing UG and PG syllabus for various colleges. All along the way, he has also framed and evaluated question papers for reputed colleges in Chennai. He is also a socially active member in Outreach and Stand, which is an outreach program which motivates the students to work in remote villages, conducting awareness program, teach and motivate the children towards higher studies, and study their day-to-day problems and work towards the solution. Computers are able to see, hear, and learn, and machine learning is the next internet. We have seen machine learning as a buzzword for the past few years. The reason for this might be the high amount of data production by applications, the increase of computational power the past few years, and the development of better algorithms. Machine learning is used anywhere from automating mundane tasks to offering intelligent insights. Industries in every sector try to benefit from it. You might have been using a device that utilizes it. For example, a wearable fitness tracker like Fitbit or an intelligent home assistant like Google Home. Now, our resource person is going to enlighten us on the insights of machine learning and its inferences in various areas. Participants, kindly post your queries in the chat box and they will be addressed once the session nears its end. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for your nice introduction.
Thank you, sir.
Very good evening, all of you. Before I'm going to proceed with the session, let me take this opportunity to thank the management of Annai Violet College, the principal, the head of the Department of Computer Science and Computer Applications, and the faculty members from Computer Science Department and other faculty members and HODs of Annamalai College. Thank you very much for the great opportunity for sharing my knowledge with you people. Today, we are going to discuss the very emerging technology, machine learning. Why machine learning is a very emerging technology? Because we have developed so many softwares, web applications, mobile applications. With these softwares, we have generated huge volume of data. Here, we are going to extract knowledge from this data. This is exactly data science or machine learning. I'll tell you the difference between data science and machine learning a bit later. Simply, we are going to extract the knowledge from the data. You may have a wonder how we can extract knowledge from the data. So I wish all of you live with good health for 100 years. Let us assume you are not feeling well. What you will do? Obviously, you'll consult a doctor. There are two options. 55 years old doctor, 35 years old doctor. 35, 55. Which doctor you prefer? Can anyone answer my question? You are not feeling well. You are going to consult a doctor. There are two options. 35 year old doctor, 55 years old doctor. Which doctor you prefer? Okay. Can anyone answer my question, Sudhama? Or Vinod sir, 55. Yeah, 55. Why 55? Because of experience.
Having experience, yes.
Exactly, exactly. What is experience? Experience is knowledge, right? In other words, I can say the data stored in the doctor's mind. By using the human intelligence, the doctor convert the data into a knowledge and give the treatment. So because of that only you prefer 55 years old doctor. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So the data stored in the doctor's mind. Here, the data stored in the computer memory. By employing some of the machine learning algorithms, we are going to extract the knowledge from the data. So exactly we are going to do the same in machine learning. Right? So why all the people running behind the data scientist or machine learning technology? Because it reduced the cost 30%. Suppose in a project, if you want to spend 1,000 crores, mean you can complete the project within 700 crores by taking the appropriate decision. Right? I told you earlier. So we are going to take or extract the knowledge from the data. First, we need to understand what is data. What is data? What is data? This is very simple question only, but for others, computer science easily maybe answer this question. What is data? Some of you think that data is information, but that is not correct. Data is a raw fact. So when we are processing the data or organizing the data, we'll get information. For example, simply I am telling you number 26. What is this? Is it information? Simply I am telling 26. Is it information? No. So I'm going to process the data. What manner? By putting what subject, verb, some adjectives and all. I'm processing the data. I'm forming a sentence. There are 26 donkeys. My age is 26. This is information, right? So when we are processing the data, we'll get information. Sometimes when we are organizing the data, we'll get information. For example, 26. Let us assume I'm having a table with the two columns. The first column getting name, second column getting age. Under name, I am putting Vijay. Under column name, getting age, I am putting 26. What is 26 now? The age of Vijay. Here, I am not processing the data, I am organizing the data. So when I'm organizing or processing the data, I'll get information, right? So from the data, we are going to extract the knowledge, right? First, we need to understand what is human learning. What is human learning? Then we move on to machine learning, right? What is human learning? Let us assume. So take 2 year old child, right? So you ask the child to classify cat or tiger. You are showing cat photo and ask the child, what is this? The child couldn't classify, right? You are showing tiger photo, the child don't know what it is, right? So in what manner you can train the child? So you can take 50 photos of cat, 50 photos of tiger, right? 50 photos of cat, 50 photos of tiger. And you are showing the child, this is cat, this is tiger, this is cat, this is tiger. Like that, you train the child with 100 photos. Now I'm having 101 photo, right? I'm showing that photo to the child. Can you tell me what is this? Now the child easily says this is tiger or this is cat. Like that easily the child can classify it, because already you train the child. This is exactly human learning. The same way we are going to train the algorithm to classify certain things, whether this is this type of cancer or that type of cancer. Or else I can say, this is what, whether I can sanction the loan for this particular person or not, that can be, we can do, right? So likewise, we can train the algorithms for classification purpose or regression purpose or association rule mining purpose. Everything we are going to see now, right? Now, in traditional or conventional programming language, we are write the program, give the input, and we'll see the output, right? In conventional programming language, we are writing the code. For that, we are giving the input, then we will get the output. So the input processed by the program and generate the output. But in machine learning, we are going to give the input as well as the output to the machine and ask the machine to write the code. This is exactly what we are going to do in machine learning. I repeat, in machine learning, we are going to give input as well as the output and ask the machine to write the code, right? So everything we will see. So I'll share my screen from which I would like to continue my presentation, right? Fine. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Just a minute.
Okay, sir.
Normal. Is it okay now?
Clear, sir.
Yeah, fine, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you very much. First, we are going to understand what is data science. So the topic is about machine learning, Now I am going to tell you the correlation or link between data science and machine learning. So data science is an umbrella term under which only we have machine learning. Data science is an umbrella term under which only we have machine learning. See here, easily you can understand. Data science is a science, so we can not only a single field: computer science, statistics, machine learning, visualization, and human-computer interaction to collect, clean, integrate, and analyze, and also visualize data. This is exactly data science, right? Under which only we have machine learning. So, for what purpose we are using data science? As I told you earlier, easily you can understand, many discipline involved: computer science, statistics, the domain experts, all business, all then put together and come out with a new technology called data science. It is a scientific process for converting the raw data into a knowledge. Simply, we are going to convert the raw data into a knowledge. We are going to find the pattern. We are going to find the pattern. I'll tell you what is pattern and all while we are discussing classification techniques. So just we are going to find the pattern from the data. So what is the goal? To improve business, society, or personal performance by gaining knowledge from data. So these are all some of the goals of data science. So pictorial representation from which easily you can understand. So many field involved under data science. What are the tasks? Data analysis. What percentage of user back to our site, our website, begin? Which products usually bought together? We can do that by using what association rule mining technique, a priori algorithm, or effective growth algorithm. Easily we can do that. In modeling or statistics, how many cars we are going to sell next year? How many cars we are going to sell next year? Which city is better for opening new office? In engineering prototyping, product to use a prediction model. So we can predict the product, what product is what. In future, we'll get more demand. We can predict. Visualization of analytics, right? So we can visualize. In clustering techniques, I'll show you in what manner we can visualize everything. Human versus machine. You know very well, naturally can work with small amount of data, have a knowledge about domain, good image recognition. These are all some of the points for human. Machines can make intensive computation, knows only numbers and strings. Well, only actually numbers, binary form, you know, all of you are very familiar with that. Data scientist is the best job of 21st century. I'm not telling this. Harvard Business Review, right? So what about the salary for data scientists? Top most salary in US as well as what in India? Top most salary by Glassdoor. So this is by Glassdoor. So data scientist salaries, junior, senior. The second top most salary by BI developers. Then third top most salary, Java developers. Right? So by all means, what I'm trying to say is data science is what a number one field for job as well as the research. Right? Why data science? For credit rating or target marketing. What do you mean by credit rating? So a bank manager wished to sanction a loan for a particular person. He cannot sanction loan for all persons based on certain criteria: house owner or not, house owner, yes or no, age, credit rating, then salary, number of family members. Based on certain criteria only, the bank manager can sanction the loan. So for that, for taking the appropriate decision, we can use machine learning tech. Targeted marketing. What do you mean by targeted marketing? So I think you might have get a call from HDFC or ICICI. So ma'am, we are providing loan. So we are providing car loan or house loan. Like that, you might have get a call from the banks, right? So those person cannot call all the people. So when I approach these persons, definitely this person will buy a home or will get a loan. He is eligible or potential to repay the loan properly. So like that, we need to identify the group of people. Just we can approach those people alone. Then why should I waste my energy, time, money, everything to ask all the people who are not interested, right? So we can predict these people are interested. So approach those people easily. We can what? Sell our product or ask them to get a loan. Fraud detection. We have a technique in machine learning called outlier detection. With the help of outlier detection, easily we can predict the fraud. So we have a group of clusters. If anything abnormal, automatically it will be indicated to you. Right, fraud detection. Then customer relationship management. If it is a good customer, we can easily ward, maintain. Bad customer, just ward. Leave the customer for the competitors. Right? Data science helps to extract such informations. We can extract these kind of informations. Right? As I told you, these are all some of the applications of machine learning. Wherever I am using data science, I'm using what? I'm mentioning machine learning. Right? So because machine learning comes under data science only. Data science is an umbrella term. As I told you earlier, for banking, we can use. So for customer relationship management, we can use targeted marketing, fraud detection, then manufacturing and production. So automatically their knob can be adjusted by employing machine learning algorithms. Right? So in medicine, so if a particular person get this disease, automatically this person get this disease also. What about the relation or correlation among the disease? That can be easily we can find using what association rule mining. Then molecular pharmaceutical identify new drugs. The new drugs can be identified with the help of machine learning. Then scientific data analytics. So we can find out the subclusters, galaxy. The galaxy of subclusters, easily we can find out. Then, so what about the affinity of the user about the web pages? So in which web page the user are very interested? So that can be identified with the help of machine learning. Right, these are all some of the applications of machine learning. Now, technically, we are going to see one after another. Some basic operations in predictive analytics and descriptive analytics. In predictive analytics, we have a techniques called regression and classification. In descriptive, we have clustering, association rules, and deviation detection. These are all some of the basic operations of machine learning. Now I'm going to explain one by one. To understand these concepts, you need to understand certain variables. The first one, dependent variable. The other one, independent variable. What do you mean by dependent variable? The variable which depends the other variable, which means the change in one variable depends upon the change in another variable, is called dependent variable. Independent variable, the variable which causes the change in the dependent variable, is called independent variable. For example, let us take two variables. The first one is what sales, another one, advertisement expenditure. These are the two variables. Which one is the dependent variable here? Obviously, sales, because sales depends on the advertisement expenditure. How much you are spending for advertisement, based on which your sales also will increase. Right? So sales is a dependent variable. Advertisement expenditure is a independent variable. So I have another name for independent variable called explanatory variable. Why it is called as explanatory variable? Because this advertisement expenditure will explain sales. If I spend this much amount, then what? I'll get what? This much sales. So that will explain sales, because I'm telling that was for explanatory variable. So when you see the other variables in the third point, sales depends upon advertisement expenditure, quality of service, quality of product, and etc. Here, sales is a dependent variable. The rest of the variables are the independent variables or explanatory variable. So based on these independent variable or explanatory variable, I am going to predict the sales. I hope you are very clear about dependent variable and independent variable. Right. In general, in machine learning, we are using the terminology or term called model building. Model building. What do you mean by model building? I'll show you. Before that, I am telling you the technique called feature selection or extraction, right? So most of the people are thinking that feature selection and extraction are similar. Let me tell you what is feature selection and what is feature extraction. It is feature selections. I may have n number of variables. From n number of variables, all the variables may not be relevant variable. Some of the variables are relevant. Some of the variables are irrelevant, right? Just I'm going to identify and keep only the relevant variables. The irrelevant variables can be eliminated while we are building the model, right? So that is exactly called feature selection. Then what do you mean by feature extraction, right? Sometimes among the independent variables or explanatory variable, among the explanatory variable, we have high correlations. When we have the high correlation among the explanatory variable, we have the problem called multicollinearity problem. To avoid this kind of multicollinearity problem, we are combining two or three variables as a single variable. I repeat, just combining more than one variable as a single variable is called feature extraction. So from n number of variables, I'm going to select only a few variables which are relevant, that is called feature selections, right? So this is what model building strategy. So when you see this example, easily you can understand, right? Easily you can understand what is feature selection. This is the example for feature selection. I'm having the dependent variable called result. So I'm going to predict or classify the result of a particular student, whether the student will get pass or fail. Right, based on hours studied per day, height, attendance percentage, hair color, skin color, time spent on social media, weight. So these are all my independent variables, based on which I am going to predict the dependent variable over here. What is dependent variable? Result. Okay, so I am going to build a model. I am going to build a model with all these variables, right from hours studied per day to weight. I'm going to utilize all the variables. The model says, if the person is what? White, he'll get pass. அப்படி மாடல் சொல்லுது. ஒரு பையன் சகப்பா இருந்தா பாஸ் பண்ணிடுவான் அப்படின்னு மாடல் சொல்லுது. Will you accept that? Or else, ஒரு பையன் நல்ல ஹைட் வெயிட்டா இருந்தா அவன் பாஸ் ஆகிறான் அப்படின்னு சொல்லுது மாடல். Will you accept that? Right? So we cannot use all the variables. Some of the variables are relevant. Here, easily you can identify by putting a visual inspection. Easily you can say, this is what relevant, this is what irrelevant. But in general, technically, in real-time application, you cannot classify. So this is relevant or irrelevant. We can build a model by using what? Certain technology, forward selection, backward elimination, like that what? So many methods are there, right? So by using those methods, we can select the appropriate. See here, I'm going to select the appropriate variables or the relevant variables to classify the result, right? So some of the variables are in green color, some of the variables are in red color. So the green color variables are relevant variables, the red color variables are irrelevant variables. So I'm eliminating height, hair color, skin color, white, and I'll keep only what? The rest of the variables, selected variables. Hours studied per day, attendance percentage, time spent on social media, like that. Right? So this is what feature selection. So now we are going to see the very important concept called what? Classification, which comes under supervised learning. What do you mean by supervised learning? You are going to learn with the teacher. If you learn with the teacher, that is comes under supervised learning. I'll tell you what we are going to do. Simply, I am going to explain the classification technique. For example, you are having four groups of balls, four colors of balls with four groups. Red color, one group. Green color, another group. Blue color, another group. Yellow color, another group. When a new ball comes, it does not belong any group. A new ball comes. I put the new ball in which group? I am going to classify that. That is exactly called classification, supervised learning, right? So I repeat. So I'm having four groups of balls with the different colors. When the new ball comes, I can place the new ball in which group? In the group la adu poi poda poran. That is what classification. Now I am going to compare this same example, this example with the real time application. I am having diabetes patient data set. Diabetes patient data sets. So I am going to predict or classify whether a particular person will get heart attack or not. Right? I am having totally 5,000 records. I am having totally 5,000 records. In these 5,000 records, 5,000 records, 3,000 records are not attacked, non-attacked, heart attack varadhavanga. Remaining 2,000 attacked, heart attack vandhavanga. I'm having two groups, so non-attack, attack, right? So based on what you are going to decide, maybe what body mass index, hypertension, cholesterol, decoding usage. So likewise, I'm having n number of variables. Right, based on these variables, I am going to classify whether a particular person will get heart attack or not. Right, as of now, already I know 5,000 records. For 5,000 records, 2,000 people attacked, 3,000 people non-attacked, which means I am having two groups, attacked, non-attacked. So when a new person comes, I don't know whether the person belongs to attacked group or non-attacked group. I'm going to put the new person's detail, like what body mass index, cholesterol, nicotine usage, gender, hypertension, like that. I'm having the details of a particular person. I don't know that person will get heart attack or not. So I'm going to classify. If I put that person in attack group, that person very soon going to get a heart attack. If I classify that person into non-attack, that person will not get heart attack. So likewise, easily we can predict whether a particular person will get heart attack or not. Simply, I'm telling you, there are some of the complicated examples. Right, what? The doctor themselves couldn't classify whether this type of cancer or that type of cancer. Right? So easily we can employ machine learning algorithms and classify what type of cancer it is. Right? So I want to remove only the cancer cell. The doctor couldn't classify which one is normal cell, which one is the cancer cell. Algorithm says this is normal cell. This is what cancer cell. Remove this alone. Right? Likewise, easily we can classify n number of applications for classification. Right? So see here, this is exactly model building. This is exactly model building. So I have the data sets. See the data set. Outlook, homework done, weekend, play. Totally, I'm having four variables. The first three variables are the independent variables. The last one dependent variable. Very simple. I'm going to build a model for a mother. Or amma ku model build pandren. Ad amma anga payana or ponnayo velila veladradhukku permit pannalama venama. Whether I can permit my students to play or not. Right? Play yes or no. I need to what? Classify. Based on what? Outlook. Homework done. Weekend. If outlook is sunny, see the first row, sunny, true, yes. Then see the third row, rainy, false, no. Right? So these are all the data set I have with the two category, yes, no. So if I know only the first three variables, easily I can predict what? The play yes or no. Right? From this data set, so we are called as what? Training data. By employing the classification algorithm, we can, from the data, the algorithm learn everything. If this is what? Sunny, then homework done true, weekend true, then play, yeah, play is what? Yes. Then take the last one, if the outlook is rainy, homework done true, then weekend false, then what? No. Likewise, the algorithm learn from the data set and what? Build a model. So classifier, see the classifier, that is our model, right? Now I am going to give what? The testing data, right? When I give the test data, automatically it says what? Whether you can allow the person to play or not, that can be easily said. Because already learned by the model, by the classifier, right? Easily we can say, right? See the example. Ma'am, can you see my screen fully?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, it's visible, sir.
Yeah, fine. See here. So directly I'll go to this example. See here, the first one, the data set. This data set, right? That is called what? Training data set. We are going to train the model. So learn classifier, model build. I'm going to test. So in general, then if you are having the 1,000 records, I can separate the records into 80%, 20%. Why? Because of cross-validation. What do you mean by cross-validation? Then if you train with all the records and test with all the records, the accuracy may be what? 100%. Accuracy may be 100%. Easily said. Simple. In a simple way, I already explained. You are conducting internal. Internal 1, internal 2. In semester examination, you are asking the same question. What will happen? Easily, the boys will score well, you know. Internal vandha adhe kelvi da semester ku vandirukku. Obviously, mark vaangiruvaan, easy ah nalla vaangiruvaan. Based on which we cannot say what the students are studied well. Romba nalla padichaan, semmaya concept la learn pannitaam solla mudiyadhu. Right? So internal question is separate. Semester question, internal la endha question vandirukkano, adhayum taandi vera question vandirukkano. Appa semester la perform panninaa nalla pannina da, we can easily say what the boys are what really studied well. Right? Adhanaala da enna pandrom, with 880% of the data we can train, remaining 200% model paakada data. So on the 200% model paakada data la, if the model performs well, automatically we conclude that the model learns well. 200, let us assume the first table la vandu 800 records irukku, model train pandinga, remaining 200 model paakada 200, so you ask the model to predict yes or no va appu kekkuringa, model correct ah perform pannudhu. Out of 200, 180 correctly classified, 20 wrongly classified. The accuracy of the model is 90%. 200 to 180, 100 to 90% accuracy. If the model is what? Accurate, then only we can use the model for real-time application. Right? So this is a decision tree example. Simply, I already explained. See here. I'm having the decision tree. Refund. So based on certain criteria, the bank manager is going to decide whether the particular person will cheat or not. Cheat pannuvara panna mattara appo classify pannum. Refund, I'm having the pattern. Totally, I'm having 1, 2, 3, 4 patterns. What is 4 pattern? Refund, yes, appunaka no, cheat panna mattara, first pattern. Refund, no, appuna I can't say, enala solla mudiyala. Then I'll check what marital status also. Marital status, single divorce. Or marital status undu married appunaka no, cheat panna mattara. See, the first branch, left side, refund, yes, naave, cheat panna mattara, no, avan mudi panniruvaan. Refund, no, I can't decide. Appa marital status check pandren. Marital status married, appa enna pandren? So refund, no, marital status married naaka, cheat, no, cheat panna mattara. Right? If refund, no, marital status, single or divorced, appa naaka I can't decide, I'll see one more variable, taxable income. The taxable income greater than 80k, cheat, yes. If the taxable income less than 8k, cheat, no. Totally, I'm having 4 patterns, right? See here in what manner. So this is the test data. I'm having a person, detailed, refund, no, marital status, married, taxable income, 80k. So I'm going to classify whether the particular person will cheat, yes or no? Cheat panuvara panna matara? See here, refund, no. Marital status, married. Then what? Assign cheat to no. So this particular person will not cheat. Right? So this is exactly classification technique. Right? So these are all some of the applications of classification. So direct marketing, easily we can predict who are all likely to buy a computer. Simply we can approach those people alone. Right? Fraud detection, I told you earlier. Right? So finally, we move on to the clustering techniques. Very beautiful. Unsupervised learning. Right? See here, why we call this as a supervised learning? You can see from the data. See here. See this data set. Outlook sunny, homework done, weekend. These are all the input. What about the output? Play. Play. Yes, yes, no, no. That is the output. I'm giving the input as well as the output. These three, outlook, homework done, weekend are the what? Inputs. The play is the output. I'm giving the input as well as the output. Though the play is the teacher. Play is the teacher. I know if it is on sunny, homework done true. If it is weekend, yes, I know. I know this dependent variable value. Because of that, I'm telling that as supervised learning. The play, the dependent variable value is a teacher here. But in unsupervised learning technique, we don't have what? That kind of variable. Simply, I'm having the variables. There is no difference of independent variable and dependent variable. Simply, I'm having the variables from which I'm going to tell you what we can do, right? What we can do, right? Let me tell you. So there are some of the algorithms, k-means, k-medoids, agglomerate clustering, then density-based clustering. Like that, I'm having n number of clustering algorithms. For classification, I'm having CART with classification and regression trees, random forest, support vector machine, kn and kth nearest neighbor algorithm, naive Bayesian. Like that, n number of algorithms are available. You can make use of any one of the algorithm and perform classification as well as what the clustering, right? See here. Finally, so what do you mean by clustering? You people are very familiar with clustering, the word cluster, right? Just we are going to group, right? So with these algorithms, we can form a group. Now, I am going to tell you the classic example or applications of clustering. See here. So I wrote the code in Python for implementing this. This is what visualization. So visualization. So I'm interpreting the result. So see here, at the x-axis, I'm having annual income. I'm having two variables. See, in x-axis, I'm having annual income. In y-axis, I'm having spending score. Evlo selavu pandranga, evlo sambarikranga, evlo selavu pandranga. These two variables. There is no category here. Independent variable nu kediyadu, dependent variable kediyadu. Just the variable, that's all. In classification only we have what? Dependent variable, independent variable and all. But here simply I'm having variables. Let us assume I'm having two variables. Annual income, right, in x-axis. Spending score in y-axis, right? So totally, I'm having five clusters. Let us take cluster one. Cluster one, red color. See the x-axis, annual income. எவ்வளவு இருக்கு? நோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுவோம், கிளஸ்டர் ஃபைவ்ல இருந்து வரும். சி கிளஸ்டர் ஃபைவ் பிங்க் கலர், ரைட்? கிளஸ்டர் ஃபைவ் பிங்க் கலர். வாட் அபவுட் தி ஆனுவல் இன்கம்? ஸ்மாலா தான் இருக்கு பாருங்க, 20 to 40 தான் இருக்கு. ஸ்பெண்டிங் ஸ்கோர் பாருங்க, அதே 20 to 40 இருக்கு. கம்மியா சம்பாதிக்கிறாரு, கம்மியா செலவு பண்றாரு. பிங்க் கலர் கிளஸ்டர் ஃபைவ். Then C, cluster 4 on the top. For cluster 4, paarenga x axis la paathumna 20 to 40 la romba kammiya sambaadikiraaru ana selavu pandrathu bayangaram selavu pandraaru. 80 100 ku spending score. Cluster 4 bayangaram selavu pandraaru. C, cluster 3 green color. cluster 3. So spending score பார்த்தாலும் ஹையா இருக்கு. annual income அதிகமா சம்பாதிக்கிறாரு, அதிகமா செலவு பண்ணிடுறாரு. ரைட், நிறைய சம்பாதிக்கிறார், நிறைய செலவு பண்றாரு. green color. See the blue color. blue color, that is what, cluster 2. மீடியமா சம்பாதிக்கிறாரு பாருங்க, 42-60 குள்ள இருக்கு, அங்கேயுமே 42-60 மீடியமா சம்பாதிக்கிறாரு, மீடியமா செலவு பண்றாரு. ஓகே, சி கிளஸ்டர் 1 ரெட் கலர், அதிகமா சம்பாதிக்கிறாரு பட் ரொம்ப கம்மியா செலவு பண்றாரு. டார்கெட் மார்க்கெட்டிங், இப்ப யார் நம்மளோட டார்கெட், எந்த குரூப் ஆஃப் பீப்புள் டார்கெட் ஆடியன்ஸ், டார்கெட் பர்சன்ஸ் ஃபார் செல்லிங் மை ப்ராடக்ட். இட் மே பி த கம்ப்யூட்டர் ஆர் இட் மே பி த ஹோம், ஒரு ஹவுஸா கூட இருக்கலாம். ரைட், கிளஸ்டர் 1 இஸ் அ டார்கெட் பர்சன்ஸ். ஏன் அப்படின்னாக்க, அவர் அதிகமாக சம்பாதிக்கிறாரு, ரொம்ப கம்மியாக செலவு பண்ணுறாரு, விஷ் மீன் அவரோட நிறைய பணம் கையில் இருக்கு. கொஞ்சம் ஏதாவது நான் ஆஃபர் தரேன் அப்படின்னு கொஞ்சம் அவரோட ஸ்டிமுலேட் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னாக்க, மேபி வாட் ஓவர் த ஃபோன் பேசி, சார் இந்த ஆஃபர் தரோம், அந்த ஆஃபர் தரோம், தென் வாட் ஒன்று வாங்கினா ஒன்று ஃப்ரீ, லைக் தட் இஃப் யூ ஆர் சேயிங் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி யூ கேன் செல் யுவர் ப்ராடக்ட். ரைட், கிளஸ்டர் 1. ஸோ லைக் வைஸ் வி கேன் செல் அவர் ப்ராடக்ட். ரைட், ஃபைன். ஸோ சம் ஆஃப் தி அப்ளிகேஷன் ஏரியாஸ், இண்டஸ்ட்ரி ஃபினான்ஸில் கிரெடிட் கார்டு அனாலிசிஸ் யூஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க, தென் இன்சூரன்ஸ் செக்டார் கிளைம்ஸு, ஃப்ராட் அனாலிசிஸ், டெலிகம்யூனிகேஷன் கால் ரெக்கார்ட் அனாலிசிஸ், இன் டிரான்ஸ்போர்ட்டில் லாஜிஸ்டிக் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் யூஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க, கன்சியூமர் குட்ஸ் ப்ரொமோஷன் அனாலிசிஸ், டேட்டா சர்வீஸ் ப்ரொவைடர்ஸ், வேல்யூ ஆடட் டேட்டா, தென் யூட்டிலிட்டிஸில் பவர் யூசேஜ் அனாலிசிஸ், லைக் திஸ். தீஸ் ஆர் த சம் ஆஃப் த அப்ளிகேஷன் ஏரியாஸ் ஆஃப் டேட்டா சயின்ஸ். So in many other aspect we can use what data science. Now I'm going to tell you the market buzz. Worldwide data analytics market to grow to 203 billion US dollar from 130 billion in the 203 billion US dollar grow agudhu 2020 la aayirukku. IDC, by IDC, data scientist is the number one best job in USA. Glassdoor, shortage of 1.5 million business analytics professionals. McKinsey, close to 90,000 positions related to data analytics are advertised every month in 2018-19 by Analytics India magazine. Data scientists earning much more than CAs and IT professionals. Times of India, annual demand for data scientists, data developers and data engineers will reach nearly 7 lakh openings by 2020, IBM. So obviously, so data science is an emerging technology from which easily you can understand. So very emerging technology for job opening also, as well as the research area. Right? So thank you very much. Then if you want to clarify anything, you can ask me now. Thank you. Ma'am, can you hear me?
Ah, yes, sir. One second, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks a lot, sir, for this informative and delightful session. A gentle reminder to the participants, kindly subscribe the channel for further updates and click the feedback link in the chat box to fill the feedback form so as to receive your e-certificate within a week to your registered email ID. Now, we will move on to the question answer session. Sir, we have few questions, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
How will I know which ML algorithm I should choose for a given problem or data?
Yeah, fantastic. But in general, we cannot say by putting a visual inspection. Simply see, and say this is best, that is best. I can't say.
Okay, sir.
We need to use. Okay. The algorithm, employ the algorithm in the data set, then only we can say. In general, for most of the data set, random forest is the best algorithm for all the, because ensemble technique. We are using ensemble technique. So most promising classifier, in some situation, SVM, support vector machine, overcome random forest. So these are the two best, most promising classifiers. either we can go with random forest or SVM. If it is what, if the data set contains non-linear decision boundary, you may go with the SVM.
Okay.
Right? If it's a normal data set, go with the random forest.
Okay. One more question, sir. Which language is used in machine learning or data science?
Yeah, in general, earlier days we used R language. But nowadays, Python is a very popular language. There are so many packages, so they are introducing for all the machine learning algorithms. Even we can use what image also. We can classify image also. There are so many packages available. Python is the best language, ma'am. Python okay. is the best language.
Okay, sir. One more question, sir. Should I always discard outliers?
Yes, obviously. We need to detect the outliers and we need to discard the outliers, because outliers or school la ella pasangalume romba worst ah irukan fail ah irukan enga endha or paiyam posa join pannitan avan 100 ku 100 mark vaangidan 500 ku out of 500 500 vaangidan andha oru vishayatha vachi andha school e top nu solla mudiyad la
then
if you are keeping outlier in your data set andha maari interpretation varadhukku vaipu irukku so okay. we need to carefully deal with the outliers
okay sir the last question sir I recently read about GPT-3 and that is was trained on data taken from internet. So will it be biased on some topics like gender, race, religion, etc.?
I don't understand the question, ma'am.
One second, sir.
Where is it from the internet?
I'll repeat the question, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
I recently read about GPT-3 and that it was trained on data taken from the internet. So okay. will it be biased on some topics like gender, race, religion, etc.?
So it depends upon the data set, ma'am. So we okay. need to see the data set. We need to see the data set, then only we can say. Once we see the data sets, we can easily say what or if it is a biased, which mean biased data set, we can use what upsampling or downsampling. We have a technique called what upsampling, downsampling. Whichever the class is what very less samples, we can boost by upsampling, or else whichever is more, we can perform what downsampling. We can maybe what avoid that biased also and all.
Okay sir. Thank you, sir, for enthusiastically answering the questions asked by the participants. Now we will wind up the session with a vote of thanks by Mrs. Gladys Thangaruby, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Application. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Very good evening to one and all. I consider this as a wonderful privilege to express vote of thanks on behalf of our college for the success of this webinar. This is my responsibility and honor to extend warm gratitude to our respected chairman of Annavalet Arts and Science College, Chevalier Dr. N.R. Dhanabalan, who is having widened vision to promote education to the unprivileged and underprivileged community. Positive leaders empower people to accomplish their goals. I express my heartfelt thankfulness to our young and energetic secretary, Mr. N.R.D. Prem Kumar, and to our dynamic and vibrant joint secretary, Dr. P.E.R. Premchand, for their significant leadership. Besides, I'm happy to highlight incomparable contribution of our principal, Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, and our vice principal, Mrs. Jafia Solomon, for making this webinar in a better standard. And I thankfully acknowledge the deep concern of our college IQAC team for seeking right opportunity to provide an attractive platform to conduct such a webinar even in the pandemic situations. The following quotation, the office of the scholar is to cheer, to rise, and to guide men by showing them facts amidst appearances. It's a very much suitable to our resource person of this webinar, Dr. S. Bharathidasan, Head Department of Computer Science, Loyola College, Chennai. He has been very closer to our minds in order to provide new dimensions and to approach modern technologies from different perspectives by presenting his topic on machine learning. Once again, I thank you, sir, on behalf of our college for your devoted presentation. I thank and appreciate our HOD, Mrs. Meenakshi, Mrs. Srividya, Dr. Sudha, and Mr. Vinod for their sincere efforts and cooperation for all the arrangements to make this webinar possible. I too remember the tireless contribution of Mr. Ivanesh and Mr. Loganathan for their technical support. Finally, I thank all the faculties and student communities from Annavalet College and other various colleges for making this time available, useful and lively. Once again, on behalf of our college, I thank each and every one of you for your active participation. Thank you.